Sing, my ravens. We'll pick up from there. Stories must wait. Now is not the time. Sing us a song. Save it for later. Strike of the tune. We need an epic tale.
There was a woman called Nal, who came by ship to Hornburg and heralded, demanding to meet King Sigvaldi, Styrbjorn's father. Nal was from Gautland. She was tall and rugged and strong, and everyone who walked near her said she smelled of men's blood. When her message was sent to our king, Nal was made to wait a full day. Yet she did not complain. She watched the waves and sang songs. Night came and...
Hush now! My blood freezes. This area is off limits. my back!
Give me the strength to give to you.
What is all this?
My life. The fruit of my work. All gathered here. And now, I lack the strength to throw it off this cliff.
You carried everything up here, only to throw it all down.
The horse did most of it. It is the only way I can send my belongings into the next world. My children will not bury it with me. They say they do not want it, but I know they will sell it all once my light burns out. Will you lend me your strength? Throw everything over the cliff. The farther you throw, the better their chance of reaching the next world.
Is that how it works? Why is everything packed in straw?
I did not want anything to break. Contains a bow given to me by Halfdan the Black, after I put an arrow under King Sigtyr's left arm.
That sounds like quite the shot.
That contains a silver harpoon head I received from King Harald, for pulling Halfdan's frozen body out of the ice.
May the gods grant you luck for your efforts!
I hope it is good luck.
Thank you for your help. You did not have to do this.
Kind and courageous people live the best lives, but it can be a difficult path to keep.
I have tried to live well. It is enough that the gods know that, even if the name Harek Gund is forgotten in Midgard.
So, what will you do now that this task is done?
Done? That was to announce my arrival. Now I leave this world. Enjoy your life. To Asgard!
What? Wait!
Thank you!
Thor's hammer. That was a shock. Gods here are vigilant. Huh. Must be black from the other side. Yeah. Best not to draw attention here.
Thank you. of idiot pieces.
Myself here.
Hamuram. Hamuram.
Volka?
Hush. I need silence to hear the songs of nature. Hamuram. Hamuram.
Svala.
She gives praises and she is greeted.
For your hearing, I hearken. O ancient ones, Great Odin, great Freya, I give you thanks for your gift of Seidr.
She gives thanks, and she is blessed.
Eivor, it has been some time. What brings you so far to see me?
I have come for your advice on a private matter.
Come.
Is your mother well?
Her mind is a jumble. She speaks to spirits. I fear her final winter has come, but she has me. Now, let us speak to your needs.
I have had a vision. A powerful vision. It may have been my battle lust, or a delirium caused by the cold, but...
Describe it for me.
After 17 years, I saw my father's axe again. And when I touched it, the vision came on fast. There was a wolf, howling and fierce. And then a figure. A greybeard in a cloak. With a single eye. He bid me follow him.
Ah, the High One. He calls to you. Perhaps he means to speak with you, deliver a message. Only through Seidr will you see more clearly, and unravel the threads that sit tangled upon your mind. This will not take long.
What are you brewing?
An elixir to loosen your hugur and unwind your thoughts. You will enter a waking sleep and journey to the world of dreams. It may confuse or disorient you, but you must take note of all you see. Drink. If you seek true understanding.
I saw nothing, Volka. Felt nothing.
Harvey!
Harvey.
Harvey!
Do I walk among the dead? Sigurd.
Sigurd! Brother! When did you arrive?
Brother! What is this?
There was no other way, Harvey. Our fates are fixed.
Sigurd! Sigurd! What is... what has happened?
This was not for you, Harvey.
Steady, Eivor. It is Valka. I am here.
God! I thought I... What was that?
Tell me everything.
I was on a mountain, in a violent blizzard, climbing toward the summit, following a wolf.
Mm-hmm.
And the wolf was eager for my attention, as if it were beckoning me to follow.
You are the Wolfkist, fated to carry its mark for life. In this case, it might represent your ambition, or your fear.
I saw the gates to Odin's Hall of slain champions. They opened for me.
Shades of Valhalla, for which you are destined.
I saw Odin and the Nornir spinning the threads of fate. They were watching me.
Not watching. They were showing you the way forward. Your life, your path, what lies before you, and where it ends.
I do not know what else to say. My memories are faint, hazy.
Did you reach the summit of this mountain?
I did, yes. Sigurd was there, wounded, in pain. His fighting arm was missing. Then the wolf reappeared, the size of a dragon, twisted and terrible. It fixed its eyes on me and struck. Then I woke.
The gods favor you, Eivor. They always have. You will have your glory, and you will earn your place in Valhalla. But these portents carry a darker truth. The missing arm, the trail of blood, the beast. You will betray your brother, Sigurd. That is the meaning of your vision.
That cannot be right. I would never betray Sigurd. He's my brother, my family.
The Nornir have spoken, and this is their message.
No, this is wrong, or you misunderstand. That cannot be right.
You will betray Sigurd.
Odin fought against his fate. It can be done.